Yes, our channel is now monetized thanks to you all. Do well to watch the ads, because if you watch the if they watch the ads for this video, and then we're gonna make some money, okay? So, but if they don't watch the ads, if they don't watch the ads, if they don't watch the ads, if you skip every single ad that comes up, you are not. I talked about the fact that apart from learning, I'm looking forward to touring the UK.
Good, yes. Yay! This is actually also important. See, another thing you need to know about these people is that
they want. Hey guys, welcome back again to part two of this collaboration with Olola Dizadi. So we have been talking about tier 4 student visa application to the UK. If you haven't watched part 1 of this video, you are missing. You need to go watch the part 1 because it's a progression of the information that we shared. We're talking about the visa interview in this particular video. Last video we talked about the documents,
applications, tuberculosis test,
costs, priority service, assisted service, and all the likes.
And my pro tip that I gave in that part
1. Hey, he gave a pro tip, you know.
Go and watch. We're gonna watch
first. Yeah, so we don't end up repeating everything. Welcome back to the channel, and do give this video a thumbs up. And before we get going, if you have any questions that we haven't covered at the end of this video, drop it in the comment section and we'll answer that for you. Also, if you have a different experience, you know, depending on your country, please share it in the comment section to help people. All right. Nobody's going to be calling your number. You have to look at the screen when your name comes up as number one.
Once your number comes up like this,
name comes up, they'll show
nobody's going to tell you. Nobody's going to say next.
Stand up.
Just stand up and go to the booth. Don't let that happen, please.
So what I did was I did my biometric. They are going to capture your thumb. You know, if you have very sensitive thumb, make sure that you don't rub something like oily on your hands. They'll capture all your thumb.
Yes.
And then they'll take a picture of you.
And that's why you need to look properly.
That's why you need to take your head to the back.
Whatever picture they take
is what's going to be on your visa.
And when you come to the UK,
it's what's going to be on your biometric, Abi.
Yes, it's something called your BRP. Your BRP, because that's also what's going to be.
That's your biometric residence permit. So you have to look good, like, you know, baby girl and baby boy.
That's a look awesome.
Yeah.
Sweet.
And your hair's to the back, because if your hair is not to the back as a lady, they're going to ask you to go out and pack your hair properly, because you have to capture your ears, your eyes, and you know, all the, you know, different parts of your face. And then you will now be asked to sit down and wait for your visa for your interview. How was your interview?
Actually, I think my interview was solid. It's not my first interview
but this time around it was for school, so it was different questions.
Yeah, it was different questions, but then I was expecting it because
Of course. Me, I did chimney interview, so I was ready. I was right. What are you going to ask me? So I went in. You know, funny enough, one thing that shocked me, I didn't know that the visa interview, that the interviewer is not in the building.
Oh really?
I didn't know.
My interviewer was in the building.
Your interviewer was a person. You saw the person.
Yeah.
Like, you sat across the human being. Yeah. Oh, my interview was virtual.
Mine wasn't.
In Lagos. Yeah. It was a white person.
And as a matter of fact, I was even an unlucky one.
Unlucky one?
Yeah, because I was just one of the few people that actually had an interview. So, there's another thing. Due to the COVID situation, some people didn't have...
Like I said, after I did my interview, the following week, like, you were no longer required to come in and do the interview.
Yeah.
So, they will now make a phone call you if they need to interview you. Some people were not
interviewed at all. But, yeah.
So, that means someone, a human being... as if a human being
I was
but the person was present.
Yeah, the person was present.
Was the person white?
Yes.
Yeah, the person always has to be from
always
UK.
Has to, yes, as
from UK. For me, it was
the questions. The questions are actually very. The questions actually see now. This is the thing. The questions are basic to
basic
the information you provided, and that is why the information you provide have to be 100% true.
Correct.
Facts.
Yeah.
Like you cannot
fabricate.
You can't fabricate. Like please.
So basically, I went into the room in Abuja. I went into the room, there was a headset. You put the headset on. It was virtual, mm-hmm. so mm-hmm. I had to look at the screen. And I think her name was Mary. I still remember her name. And then she was like, hey, Kuseme, how are you? Remember, my TV interview was virtual, so I was ready for that.
What question did they ask?
She asked me my name, my course, my university, the location.
Definitely.
Then she asked me where I was going to stay.
Those are the basics.
So you need to know your postcode, your location, where your university
you
is.
Don't really, you need to know your postcode.
You need to show, like you said, like you have just need to show knowledge. Excellence. Yes, like you are so comfortable
yes,
with this.
Yeah, you need to you show know, knowledge of the fact that
you know where you're
where
going.
You are going and you what know, you are going for.
And it also depends on the person interviewing you. I feel like the person that was interviewing me was just basic. She didn't need over the back.
No, no, no. It's not that she was basic, but
those are the basic questions.
Those are basic questions they were
and
asked.
And because I gave her so much information, she didn't have to ask me too many questions.
Yes.
She asked
yes,
me about true. My course. She asked me about like what course are you going to study, which school, and what why school? Did you choose why did the you course?
Pick? And why did you also pick the school as
the
well?
School. And then do you know where you're going to be living when you go? I'm like, okay, yeah, I've already reserved the student accommodation. Is at Stratford, is in Islington.
Yes, I think this is another thing we almost skipped, which is your place of residence.
It's very important
that if you're going to take up student accommodation, I think you'll be left off the hook a little bit. Since it is student accommodation provided by the school
yeah.
then you are fine. But if you are going to be You're going to have to live on your own.
Maybe live in a hotel
or
first.
Or live in a hotel first. Or
you
rent
have
an
to
apartment.
Show that you've even booked the
you
hotel.
You have to show that you booked the hotel. If yes. you're renting an apartment on your own, you have to show that you have a tenancy agreement. Like that is Ooh. So very, that is extremely
Did you
important.
Show your flight ticket at
no,
the interview?
No, I didn't.
So they didn't ask you for, did they because ask I, you if you had booked?
Took my flight ticket. Yes, they did.
Yeah, and okay, no. they asked you.
Yes, and no, and the reason why they just asked if I booked, but they were mm-hmm. only asking because of they know that I have already booked. Now, why did mm-hmm. they know? You have to take the coronavirus test, and one of the criteria for taking coronavirus test is submitting a tentative date of when you want to travel. Because your coronavirus test mm-hmm. needs to be 2 days before you travel.
Okay.
Yes. Oh, yes. Your test will expire.
Well,
this is as at when I did mine. I don't know what.
It's still the same thing because you have to do your test at least 72 hours before you travel, and it is airline specific.
Airline specific.
So depending on the airline you're traveling.
So when they asked me, they just asked, "Oh, have you booked a flight ticket?" I was like, "Yes," and I've also taken the test as well. So you know, I just added that because they know that for me to have taken the test, I must have booked at least.
So you have to be very confident, guys. See, that's not the place to stammer.
Yeah,
you
it's not a place to stammer.
Have to be. You know what? She asked me. She asked me who is my sponsor. Then I talked about Chibli. She was like, "Oh, you're a Chibli scholar." I said, "Oh yeah, I'm a Chibli scholar."
Now that you mentioned who is your sponsor, now that you mentioned who is your sponsor again, you know, she's talking from the fact that she got the scholarship.
Yeah.
I'm talking from self-sponsored. Since yeah. I'm self-sponsored, one of the questions that will most likely come up would be, "You have a job, especially mm-hmm. if you actually do have a job. Mm-hmm. Are you coming back?" Because that is another thing. They might not necessarily ask you like, "Are you coming back directly?" But they would.
What would you be doing after your studies?
Exactly. What would you be doing after your studies?
Yeah.
You don't want to see you are going to stay in the UK. Yes. Some of you are looking at me like, "Oh, but yeah, we want to stay in the UK."
But how about the?
You don't want to actually.
How about
that.
The fact that there's this 2 years post study visa? I want to take advantage of that. So yeah. Shouldn't you talk about that?
No, don't necessarily want say you want to take advantage.
Don't act like you are desperate to stay in the UK. You are going to study.
Exactly. Stick yeah. to you.
You're
are going to
study.
Study.
Once you finish your studies, you're coming back to your country because you're so passionate about your post-study career.
Exactly. You're passionate about your post-study career. The reason you want to advance your career, and that is why you felt that coming to study in the UK is an opportunity for you to advance that career. And that is why when you are done with your studies in the UK, you are going back to apply the knowledge you've gained here in your own country. That is what they want to hear.
And
see, it's not that they don't know. They know that you are most likely going
to stay, but they just want you to show that
exactly.
you're not desperate.
You're not desperate to stay.
And I think I gave out a lot of information in my
don't talk about it. Don't talk about that. They are going to take advantage of the 2 years. Don't talk about it.
Not important.
Not
so
important.
Make also note that the person interviewing you is writing every single thing you are saying.
Not just
they
like,
are typing it. Every single word from your mouth.
I will even say that they're even typing or they're writing.
They are recording.
They are more like they are confirming because
yeah.
they already have your information.
Because they already have.
They have everything. So mm-hmm. what you are saying, they are just in the checklist.
Is it in line?
Is it in line?
Yeah.
Is it in line?
And then she wrote down. I was just surprised that this lady is typing every single thing I'm saying. I even went as far as talking about my course because she asked me, why are you passionate about your course? Why did you choose that course? I talked about it. I mentioned my lecturers. I even mentioned a publication that my lecturer has.
That is
you know,
very
she
helpful.
Wrote it down.
Yeah, that is very
she
helpful.
She wrote the publication.
Because
she wrote the name of my...
You're going to confirm. That is actually very helpful.
What if I was lying?
Yes, that is very helpful. This is why you should not lie. Please.
You can't.
Do not lie. If you do not know anything about your school, go and research.
Go and check your school.
You don't
websites.
Need to know names. Many
like,
names.
Know
but
a
just,
few names of your professors.
At least your main course. Mm-hmm. The good thing is that for schools in the UK, for the course that you apply for and you get an admission for, mm-hmm. they would list at least
one
professor,
talk about the course
doctor,
convener,
the course convener, Vina, somebody there,
the topics
alumni,
you're going to learn.
You know, those are things that you just want to look
when
at,
you see the course
for.
Convener, click it there, read about him. Everything I read was on the website, you know, of my school.
The only information you need is at your fingertips.
Your
guys.
Visa
so
interview
please.
Is to elicit your familiarity with your program, your institution, and where you're going to stay and why you are coming to me. You know, I talked about the fact that, oh, I'm all, apart from learning, I'm looking forward to touring the UK.
Good. Yes.
Yay!
This is actually also important. See,
another
thing you need to know about these people is that
they want to hear about your excitement.
They want to know your
how
interest.
How excited
you are to come to their
culture.
They just want to hear, oh, I'm coming to study. They're also coming to see the site.
Yeah.
If you are coming
I told
to,
her that I can't wait to go to London. I want to watch live football.
One of the things I said was that in line with my course, I would like to take a tour of the UK, especially mm-hmm. Canary Wharf.
Mention the names.
Canary Wharf, because of Canary Wharf is one of the financial
cities,
capitals of London, basically the financial capital
but
of the world.
But
Canary Wharf has like headquarters of a lot of financial organizations.
Yeah.
You know, Canary Wharf and Bank.
Canary Wharf is like the Silicon Valley of
yes.
the UK, basically.
So, in terms of finance.
Well, whatever it is, I don't know.
So my point is, I chipped this in saying, oh, I'm going to take a stroll and tour around these places
around
because
place.
I know that it's part of, you know, why I am studying this course. You know, these financial organizations are there. Mm-hmm. They want to see that you have an interest in their culture.
Yeah, I even said
their way
something
of
like,
life.
Yeah, I said, oh, I hear they drink a lot of coffee in UK. I want to go and learn it. Just show excitement.
Just show excitement.
And mention locations, mention names, you know. I think it just helps. We are not saying that if you don't do these things, you will not get your visa. We are only saying that what is going to make you is your process very easily, okay?
The thing is, again, I will keep saying this until tomorrow, it is better to overcharge than to
undercharge. It is better to err
so,
on the side of excess
exactly
than deficit.
So just get all the information you need
right.
and spill everything out, you know.
Yeah.
Let them enjoy
it. Be excited
day.
And be consistent
excited.
In the information you give in your visa application.
Exactly.
And don't be too fast when speaking because they are writing. If you're too fast, they are definitely going to ask you to either stop or repeat yourself. And you don't want to
repeat yourself.
Somebody like me that the person was writing, you know, and she wasn't even
no,
there.
You're a lawyer
it was
now.
Virtual.
You know how to talk.
So I was kind of like, I felt like she was slowing me down because she was like, okay, hold on. Can you spell that for me? And then you have to spell it. See, if you mention anybody's name, you must spell the person's name.
At the end of the day, your interview is gonna be fine.
It's gonna be okay. I know you're gonna be fine. As long as you've gotten to this stage, you're definitely going to be fine. So we wish you all the very best. That's basically what your visa interview is going to look like. And prepare ask other people questions. Yes. How was their experience? Yeah. Always read the, you know, go to the UKVI website and TLS website if you're in Nigeria. Yeah,
if you want to get information, just go to the gov.uk website.
Yeah,
that's
so you're going to get a lot of information from there. And also note that whatever we have shared here is based on our personal experience. Okay, we don't work with UKVI, we don't work with the UK government. We are just doing this just to guide you guys. It's just for guidance purposes. And we are not the ones giving visa.
And help you to Japa smash. So when you eventually Japa, you remember us.
So if this video has been helpful, I want to use this opportunity to solicit for your support. Watch this video to the end.
Let me say this. Please watch this video to the end. Biko, ejo.
So watch this video to the end. The only way you show that this information that we're sharing, that we're not wasting time, that is helpful, is when you click the like button and when you drop a comment. The engagement is much, YouTube knows that this video is good. So they show it to more people like you. People looking for this information, they show it. But if you don't engage, you just watch, you laugh, you go, you jot down, but you don't engage, you don't like, you don't drop a comment, you are actually just doing us a disfavor. And also, I want to say,
doing other people a disservice too.
Yeah, and you are also doing other people a disservice because you're restricting YouTube from showing them this information. Watch the ad as well, guys. Yes, our channel is now monetized thanks to you all. Do well to watch the ads, because if you watch the
ads, I'm getting paid, right?
Oh, if they watch the art for this video, and then we're gonna make some money, okay? So, but if they don't watch the art, if they don't watch the art, if you skip every single ad that comes up, you are
I thought YouTube had that 5 second thingy.
It does. That's not watching. If you skip the ad, then nothing for us.
You can still keep money from me.
No, you have to watch it.
Oh, really? Is that how it works?
Yeah, that's how it works.
That's how it works.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you have to watch the ads. That's the only way.
Apologies to all the
apologies
to all my YouTube subscribers.
You see, this information is important. Yeah. Please don't always click the skip button. Okay. And watch at least
the ads always very annoying.
Well, that's the only way that YouTube pays, you know, creators. If you don't watch the ads, we don't get paid. I promise you. Watch the ads, like this video, share. Appreciate Olola for coming back a second time. If you haven't watched the part one of this video, do well to watch. If you have any questions, drop it in the comment section. And
don't forget to click the subscribe button.
Oh yeah. And then we're gonna bring it up to a wrap. Thank you so much for watching till the end. Meanwhile, you guys, check me out. Don't you like my makeup? Alola, what do you think about my makeup today? What kind of eyes is this now? Eh?
This is about those people.
Which people?
The application.
Which application?
Don't you like me being handsome here, Jerry?
Get out. Okay, bye, guys.
Bye, guys. Cheers.
I'm hungry.
Yeah, do your...